हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे क्लास नंबर 25 फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन 2। ओके, सो टुडेज टॉपिक विल बी द पावर एंड टॉर्क कैलकुलेशन फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन सिंगल फेज इंडक्शन मोटर। राइट, पावर एंड टॉर्क कैलकुलेशन। सिंगल फेज इंडक्शन मोटर, ओके। सो राइट, सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू फाइंड द एयर गैप पावर सप्लाइड टू द रोटर फ्रॉम द फॉरवर्ड फील्ड। राइट, एयर गैप पावर सप्लाइड फ्रॉम द फॉरवर्ड फील्ड टू द रोटर दैट इज इट विल बी डिनोटेड बाई पी जी ऑफ एफ। दैट इज जी ऑफ एफ मीन्स पावर एट द फॉरवर्ड फील्ड। ओके, एयर गैप दैट इज गैप पावर फॉर फॉरवर्ड फील्ड। ओके, सो इट विल बी ड्यू टू द करेंट आई टू एफ दैट इज द आई टू एफ स्क्वायर R2 by 2S in running condition. Okay, all we are taking in running condition. Okay, so what will be a standstill condition? So standstill condition will be, so just put S equals to 1. So it will be this one. Okay, it for standstill SS condition. SS condition means standstill condition. Okay, so next write air gap power supplied from the backward field to the rotor, that will be P of GB. That will be equals to what? That will be equals to nothing but I2B square into R2 by 2 into 2 minuses, right? It will be 2 minuses because the slip for the backward field will be 2 minuses. It will be running condition. And now P of GB dash, that is at standstill condition, if we find, then S equals to 0, then put equals to 0, it will be 4, right? At standstill condition. So it will be I2B square. Standstill condition, okay? So next write the resultant power equals to what? P of G equals to P of GF minus P of GB. Just take it R2 by 2, it will be taking common. That will be I2B square by S minus I2F square. Sorry, I2F square by S by minus I2F square into 2 minus S, right? So this is your PG. So at standstill condition it will be PGF dash minus PGB dash, right? So that will be R2 by 2, that is I2F square minus I2F square minus I2B square by 2, I2B square by 2, okay? So this is the resultant power for running condition. This is for running condition and second one is at standstill condition. Okay, so next write, what is the relation between torque to power? So forward torque. So what is forward torque? Torque produced by forward field. For torque produced by forward field, that is T of F equals to P of GF by omega S, right? That will be what? That will be I2F square R2 by 2S into omega S. Okay, it is clear. Next, backward torque what will be the backward torque? TB equals to power by angular speed. The torque is by definition, by default, the torque equals to power by angular speed. Okay, so always remember this formula. So it will be equals to this one, that is I2B squared into R2 by 2 into 2 minus s into omega s, right? 2 into 2 minus s into omega s. So what will be the resultant torque? The resultant torque will be T equals to TF minus TB. That is I2F square R2 by 2S omega S minus I2B square R2 by 2 into 2 minus S into omega S. So here you can take R2 by 2 omega S taking common, I2F square by S minus I2B square, I2F square, I2F square by S minus I2B square by 2 minus S, right? So this is your formula for resultant torque, that is air gap torque. This torque is in air gap. This torque are for are at air gap. Okay. So whatever the torque is generated at air gap. Okay, so now write rotor copper loss. Rotor copper loss due to forward field. How much? It will be PCUF equals to S into PGF. Okay. S into PGF. So S into PGF means just SS will be cancelled out. That will be I2F square R2 by 2. Right. So rotor copper loss due to backward field. PCUB. That will be S into PGB. That will be how much? It will be it will be 2 minus s multiplied by 2 minus s, because the slip is modified for the backward field. That is I2b square into R2 by 2 also. Okay, that will be they are same, right? The magnitude of their magnitude will be same, and if I2f and I2b are in same. Okay, so next write mechanical power. Next write mechanical power due to forward field. P of MF equals to P of GF minus S of, sorry, P of CUF, right? So what is the mechanical power developed due to forward field? It will be equals to nothing but your whatever the power is generated by in air gap by forward field, whatever the power is generated, whatever the power is generated in air gap by forward field, subtracted the rotor copper loss due to forward field, right? So that is PMF, mechanical power due to forward field, will be equals to PGF minus PCUF. Okay, so PGF equals to what? I2F square R2 by 2S, right? Minus PCUF equals to I2F square R2 by 2, right? So taking, so PMF equals to I2F square R2 by 2, take as common, 2S as a common, so it will be, so I think there will be a S, there will be a S, so 1 minus S will be here. Okay, so this is your mechanical power due to forward field, right? Next one, the mechanical power due to backward field. Mechanical power due to backward field. Equals to P of MB, which will be equals to P of GB minus P of CUB. GB equals to I2B square R2 by 2 into 2 minus S minus 2 minus S into I2B square R2 by 2 into 2 minus S, right? That is I2B square R2 by 2 into 2 minus S taking as common. It will be 1 minus 2 plus S, right? 1 minus 2 plus s, that will be equals to how much? S minus 1. So I 2b squared into r2 by 2 into 2 minus s will be s minus 1, right? So P of mb. So mechanical power due to backward field. So now write the total mechanical power. So total but net mechanical power. Right, net mechanical power. P of m equals to P of mf minus P of mb, right? So P of mf equals to 1 minus s into I 2f square r2 by 2s plus 1 minus that will be minus, I think, minus s minus 1 multiplied by I 2b square r2 by 2 into 2 minus s, right? So you have to solve it, right? You have to solve it. See, if we take this minus inside it, then it will be 1 minus s, and 1 minus s can be taking outside as a common. So 1 minus s into r2 by 2 can be taken outside as a common. So only thing left, I2f square by s, right? I2f square by s minus, it will be plus, right? As minus sign will be absorbed over here, so it will be modified, right? So I2b square by 2 minus s only term is left. So this is your mechanical power, total net mechanical power developed due at the rotor, okay? So next write the shaft power. So what is the shaft power? So from the mechanical power, something will be subtracted, right? Something will be subtracted, some lost power will be subtracted from this PM, you can get the PSH. So shaft power, PSH equals to mechanical power developed minus windage and friction loss, P of WF, windage and friction loss. So if we subtract it, then you can easily get the ultimate answer, okay? So PM, whatever the PM right over here, minus P of omega, windage friction loss will be PSH, right? PSH. And TSH equals to what? The torque, that is shaft torque. This is shaft power and this is shaft torque. Shaft torque equals to PSH by omega R, right? So PSH by, what is omega R? Omega R is nothing but 1 minus S into omega S. Just put it and you can easily get the ultimate answer. That is torque, shaft torque, okay? So our intention has to be develop the this shaft torque, okay? Which I have done in this class, okay? So this is your shaft torque and shaft power. So next topic will be, right, calculation of parameters of a single phase induction motor. Calculation of parameters of a single phase induction motor, that is some tests. So to calculate the parameters of single phase induction motor, we have to perform the blocked rotor test, blocked rotor test, and second one is no load test. Blocked rotor test and no load test. Okay. So make a heading first, blocked rotor test. Make a heading first, blocked rotor test. Right. To perform this test, the rotor is kept at standstill condition. To perform this test, rotor is kept at standstill condition. That is, what is the standstill condition? NR equals to 0 and AC equals to 1, right? And a very small voltage is applied to the main winding, and very small voltage is applied to the main winding so that the rated current can flow through the main winding. So a small amount of current have to be applied over the stator winding so that the rated current will flow through the stator winding, okay? So as there is a block, rotor is blocked, so small amount of voltage will produces the rated current through the stator EMF, okay, stator flux or the stator part, okay? So the rate, suppose we are taking rated current is ISC, this is a rated stator current. Okay, suppose we are taking rated stator current. Okay, so at that situation, equivalent circuit will be look like this is main winding, ISC current is flowing, this is ammeter, voltmeter, and this is wattmeter, right? So these 3 meters are needed to find some voltage, some readings. And after that, we can easily perform some extra some calculations to calculate the some parameters of a single phase induction motor. Okay, so what is VSC? Suppose this is V, suppose V, and this voltage reads VSC. Okay, VSC equals to applied voltage measured by voltmeter. Measured by voltmeter, okay. Applied voltage measured by voltmeter. And what is ISC? ISC, current through main winding measured by ammeter. Current through main winding measured by ammeter, okay. So next, WSC. And this is your WSC, okay, this wattmeter reading, right? The short circuited power measured by wattmeter, short circuited power measured by wattmeter, okay. Next, right, since the applied voltage is very low, the magnetizing current also very low, thus can be neglected, okay. So then the equivalent circuit will be, at that situation, this is the equivalent circuit of block rod test. So complete R1 X1 will calculate over here. Okay, due to simplicity, there is no need to write over here. So if we want to write R1 by 2 and X1 by 2, then you can easily take it as R1 by 2 and X1 by 2 over here. Okay. So but here I am writing for simplicity. It will be only R1 and it will be only R2. Okay. But if you wish, you can easily write over here. Okay. So this will be R2 by 2. This will be X2 by 2. And this will be your R2 by 2 and this will be your X2 by 2, okay. So write equivalent circuit at block rotor test. Equivalent circuit at block rotor test, okay. So next write. So RSC equals to what? WSC by ISC whole square, okay. WSC by RSC whole square. And this RSC is nothing but this R1 plus R2 by 2. So that will be equals to R1 plus R2 only. Okay. So RSC can be calculated by using these two. So RSC, over put the values over here. So R1 and R2 over here. Okay. So R2 can be calculated. This RSC minus R1. Okay. RSC minus R1. And R1 equals to, write, 1.2 RDC. Okay, what is RDC? I will tell you later. Okay, what is RDC? I will tell you later. Okay, so back, because you have to find the R1 first. Okay, then you can get this R2. Okay, so how to calculate this R1 and what is the significance of IDC? Okay, RDC is right over here. Stator resistance R1, right? Stator resistance R1 can be calculated or can be measured by DC voltmeter and ammeter. First, we measure the RDC. By using DC voltage source instead of AC source. So that is, I have to apply a DC voltage source to the main winding. Okay, So DC excitation of the reactance will be short circuited because we know it. The DC excitation of the short DC excitation is short circuited through the inductor. So that's why when a current is flowing from this VDC, it will only affects the resistance. So from here, the ammeter reading, from the ammeter reading, we can calculate. Suppose the ammeter reading is IDC, okay? So this RDC can be calculated. RDC can be calculated first, VDC by IDC. And R1 equals to 1.2 times of RDC, okay? This is the combination, this is the converter factor, converting factor from DC to AC part, okay? So this R1 can be calculated by this way, and this R1 will put over here, and you can get this R2, okay? So next one, right? XSC equals to root over of ZSC whole square minus RSC whole square, okay? So now I will get the result of RSC, right? So what is ZSC? ZSC equals to nothing but WSC by ISC square. WSC by ISC square equals to ZSC, because we know P equals to V square, sorry, P equals to I square into Z, right? So Z equals to P by I square. So Z equals to ZSC equals to P by I square. P can be calculated by wattmeter reading, that will be WSC, and I will be the wattmeter ammeter reading, ISC whole square. Okay, so WSC by ISC square will be produces your ZSC. Okay, so this equation you have to perform and put over the value over here, so you will get this XSC. Okay, this XSC is nothing but XSC equals to what? X1 plus X2 by 2 plus X2 by 2, similarly. X1 plus X2 by 2 plus X2 by 2, okay? So XSC equals to, right? XSC equals to X1 plus X2. Now, for any single phase induction motor, assume X1 equals to X2, right? So therefore, X1 equals to X2 equals to XSC by 2, okay? This is your ultimate result for block rotor test, okay? So this type of calculations will be made for your block rotor test, okay? So after that class, I will start the next class the numerical regarding the block rotor test and no load test. Please wait for the day. I will discuss in detail, okay? So next, write the no load test. So make a heading Roman 2, that is no load test. It is completed now. No load test. I will move into no load test. Okay. So what is no load test? Right, to perform this test, rated stator voltage VNL, is applied to, that is rated stator voltage is applied to the main winding. Okay. Main winding. That is no load means there is no load is given. Right. So if VNL is applied to the main winding, the rotor is allowed to run without any mechanical load at rated speed. So the rotor is allowed to run without any mechanical load at a rated speed NR, okay? So this NR will tends to equals to NS now, because when there is no load, then the rotor speed will achieve the synchronous speed, exactly equals to synchronous speed, okay? So when the NR is approaching this NS, then what? S tends to 0, right? When NR approaches to NS, then S will tends to 0. When S tends to 0, then what happened? R2 by 2S term will be infinity, and R2 by 2 into 2 minus S term will be R2 by 4, right? So as S equals to 0 over here, it will be R2 by 4, and if R2 by 2S term will be infinity, okay? So at that situation, this equivalent circuit will be, okay? So here, as it is an open circuited, as this R2 by 2S term is infinity, so here must have present the sum XM by 2, some XM by 2 term, okay? And now when it is in it is these terms are present, that means r2 by 4 and x2 by 2 is present over here, then actually it will be opened with respect of this one. Okay, so here only this line will be activated. Okay, so VNL will be applied over here. Okay, so the current which is flowing called INL. So right, suppose we are taking a voltmeter over here and an ammeter over here. So this ammeter will read INL and this voltmeter will read VNL. Okay, and another one, that is the wattmeter, we should have to connect. So there is a single turn and there is a, okay, this is your wattmeter. Okay, suppose you are taking, this is a R1 X1 and this is a wattmeter. Okay, so I am writing in fresh. Okay, so please wait. Okay, so this voltmeter reads VNL, here is ammeter, the ammeter reads INL and this wattmeter reads WNL. Okay, so WNL equals to VNL into INL cos phi NL. Okay, we know this formula. So this cos phi NL should have to calculate first. WNL by VNL into INL. Okay. So this sin phi NL, what will be the value? It will be root over of 1 minus cos square phi NL. Okay. Okay. Sin NL we can easily calculate. And then ZNL equals to what? ZNL equals to VNL by INL. This formula you have to apply in step by step. Okay. By step by step. So xnl equals to what? Znl, whatever the value of znl into sin theta, right? We know it. Xnl equals to znl sin theta from the triangle, from the impedance triangle, you can see that it will be r, it will be x, it will be z, right? So this will be c theta. So your x equals to what? Z sin theta. So you can write, and r equals to what? Z cos theta, right? So from this concept, you can write xnl equals to znl into sin theta. Okay? So xnl equals to what? Xnl equals to nothing but your xnl, the formula of xnl equals to what? The formula of xnl equals to x1 plus c. For this case it will be xm by 2, this is your x2 by 2 and there is no nothing will be present. Okay, so this xnl equals to x1 plus x2, this is x1, x1 plus x2 by 2 plus x m by 2, right? Xm by 2. So now xm, from this relation xm equals to what? So if we multiply over 2 over here, so 2xnl minus 2x1 minus x2, right? So this xm can be calculated by using this equation, 2xnl minus 2x1 minus x2. See, from this relation we can easily calculate the xm. So 2 will be multiplied, so 2xnl plus 2x1 shifted over here, so minus 2x1, and this x2, x2 term is also shifted over here, minus x2 will be coming, right? So here xm equals to 2xnl minus 2x1 minus x2. Okay. so x1 and x2 are the well-known quantity now, because from the block plot test you can get the x1 and x2, and here we can get this xnl, so easily calculate xm, right? So all the terms, that is rm, xm, r1, x1, r2, x2, these six terms already I have been calculated by using these two tests. Okay, these two tests. So the aim of these two tests actually to find the parameters of a single phase induction motor, right? So these are the parameters of a single phase induction motor. Okay, so this part is completed now. So next day I will do a numerical regarding this formulae as well as the block plot test and no load test. So today's class up to this much. Waiting for the next day. Thank you.